What if managing all your tasks could be both simple and powerful? In this video, I'll show you how to manage tasks in visual task boards with drag and drop simplicity. Prepare to unlock a new level of organization and collaboration. Let's dive in. On the top of the board, you can see the list of labels, the filter that you can apply on the SLA that we selected, and the list of members and assignees on the board. You can easily drag and drop these on the card. For example, you can select a label and assign it to multiple cards. You can give multiple labels to a card. When it comes to the board members and assignees, you can easily select a user, drag and drop the name to be either the primary assignee or the additional assignee. This way, you can easily assign tasks however you like to one or multiple assignees on the board. Now, let's look at some of these cards and see what options are available for us. If I open one of the cards, I can see some information. For example, changes to the state of the card, the comments left on the card, information about the assignees, the labels allocated to the card, and if there is any due date for this task. Now let's close this and try another card. As you can see, there is an attachment in this card, which I can easily open or download. I can update the short description of the card. I can add to the description of the card, and my changes are immediately reflected. I can leave additional comments, which means customers can see it. Or I can tick the box for work notes and leave an internal message. On the right pane, the first tab is a details tab, which we've already looked into. There is the assignees tab, which you can see who the primary assignee of the task is, and if there are any additional assignees. You can add additional assignees or simply promote an additional assignee to become the primary assignee of the task. Next, you see the labels. You can easily go ahead and add a couple of labels so you can filter them later on the board. The attachment tab shows all the attachments. And you can see a checklist tab. This allows you to add items and tick them on or off. Let's add a couple of items. As I'm adding the checklist items, I can see the entries in the work notes. And as I start ticking them off, I can see the work note is being updated to indicate that an item is checked off. You can remove the whole checklist, or you can save it as template so you can use it later on other tasks. This card usually shows the simple view of the record. If you want to update or see additional information, you just need to click on the hyperlink and the record opens in the default view, exactly like how you see it on the platform. You can see all the available fields on the form, plus all the tabs and related lists. You can easily make changes and update the task. Another way to access this detailed view is the hyperlinked number on the card. It opens the card in the default view automatically. The key things about visual task board is the interactivity. You can easily share a board with members, provide visibility to all the tasks you're doing, and manage your day-to-day work. The other good thing about Visual Task Board is you can add cards. In this data-driven board on incident table, adding card means creating a new incident. And similar to every incident we create on the platform, whether in the classic environment or the workspace UI, you need to fill in all the mandatory fields. Let's make it simple and submit the incident. Since we haven't defined any priority, you should be expecting to see the card in the default planning priority. You can open the incident again, update impact and urgency to be high, so the priority gets automatically updated to one critical. Now we're going to update this incident by adding a work note. And the card is now listed in the critical swim lane. Same as before, you can assign it, move the card to the next lane, reorder the card in the lane to give it a higher priority in case you want the board members to look at it first. As easy as that. Remember, you can always go to the information tab and update the filters. For example, remove the condition for the active incident, save the changes, and that refreshes the board, which means you should be able to see both closed and canceled incidents now. When adding members, remember members should have access to the incident table. In this case, you can only add users who have at least read access to the incident table. And that includes all ITIL users. And as a last note, although you usually receive notifications every time a task is assigned to you, you could also see notifications coming to your inbox if the cards change lanes. And don't forget to check the activity stream every now and then to see the latest changes applied to the board. This was an example of managing tasks in a data-driven guided board. In the next videos, we'll look into freeform and flexible boards. The journey continues.